That's one of the things about religion that we have to remember when we're talking about that makes it such a hot topic issue is because we're talking about law. Who gets to be God? Who gets to be God's deputies? Who is the Most High? Who is the divine authority? It's all about the claim to the Most High. The only way that somebody can be higher than us is if we give away our power. Because there's nobody. We're all equal. But we're not equal in our knowledge. So ultimately, I think it does have to be a hierarchy, but it has to be a cooperative hierarchy, like a bee colony. It's about what our value system is, what we care about.
Hello to the Hive Mind. Today is November 24th, 2020. I am your host, Nate Cap. Welcome to the 33rd CubbyWhole podcast, where important topics are unveiled, discussed, and tested. Our website is cubbyhole.com. That's CubbyWhole.com. And as of now, a new show is released every Monday at 6 p.m. Pacific time and every Friday at 12 p.m. Pacific time. Please make sure to start at podcast one and work your way forward so that way you gain the maximum value and understanding of the work we've laid out thus far. It's very important. You can't just, you know, come into this show and think you understand what we're really trying to say. You really do have to start at podcast one and go through each podcast show chronologically. And that way you'll really have a better understanding. You really will gain the maximum value. And it's very, 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 very important. I can't stress that enough. It's very important. Did I say that already? It's very important. Okay. I also want to thank Brandon and Doug for their awesome shows regarding methods of manipulation, which Brandon has done an excellent job of breaking down. And also Doug hosted solo on show 30. Which he did a really excellent job making sure we all understand the barriers to self-realization, which is really important, and I highly recommend going back and listening to all those shows if you have not done so yet. Like I said, very important. If we don't fully understand these topics, then we stay prone to obedience and manipulation. That's why we do this. It's about lessening the suffering in our world. And the first step is about becoming conscious, especially conscious of these, you know, types of heady topics. On this show, I'll be covering the maze cube. So basically how cul-de-sacs or traps keep us bound from growth and from finding the truth. So if you go to cubbyhole.com and click on podcast, you'll see some slides for this show, the 33rd show. So please make sure to go there and check those out. The slides really do help give these heady topics more help in our understanding. So before I get into the maze cube, I'd like to do a quick review of the topics Brandon covered so far about methods of manipulation. So just as a recap, so we're all caught up and we can, you know, move forward to the next topics. And To really fully understand these methods better, I really want you to make sure to listen to Brandon's solo shows in full. That's really important. The first method of manipulation covered was that of obfuscation. And obfuscation is the technique of distorting or skewing principle. Intended to, you know, sequester or hide truth. It's an intentional act of obscuring something like words or sciences or ideas. It's about making something into what it is not. It's about taking something that is simple and then making it more complex until it's unrecognizable. This is really what stunts people's growth in the search for truth. You know, it's a very common method that's used by the dark occultists of this world. The second method of manipulation is worldview poisoning. And worldview poisoning is the repetitive application of ideas and concepts to generate ego attachment to erroneous and dogmatic ideas about the concept of human nature. And it's poisoning because it plants the idea into our minds that human nature is inherently evil. Or, you know, the dogmatic and religious idea that, you know, we were all born into sin. And anyone that knows humans are programmable, then they know this is absolutely not true. You know, it's not true that humans are inherently evil. This method is all about keeping our minds confused and in constant opposition with love. And that's the truth. On to the third method of manipulation. This method is that of primal fears, which is what the dark occultists prey on non-stop. Primal fears are directly within the subconscious mind, and there are four of these fears. They are the fear of darkness, the fear of predators, the fear of abandonment, and the fear of chaos. And because the dark occultists or the sorcerers know how our subconscious minds work, they prey on these fears because they know they can easily control those who are not conscious of these techniques that we're speaking of. They know how most people will react to, you know, these techniques that they use. They know most people have no idea about these techniques, which makes most people vulnerable to manipulation. And that's the truth. So it's the fear of darkness, predators, abandonment, and chaos. Very important to understand fully. The fourth method of manipulation is divide and conquer. This is the divide and conquer strategy method, which is definitely about dividing humans in the mind first and getting them to fear others and build walls, especially mental walls between themselves, which then causes chaos and creates division, and it creates hatred, mostly between two opposing sides. And, you know, the obvious example would be the political arena. And this is, you know, this strategy weakens both sides, making it easier to control and conquer and, you know, incrementally take away liberties within society, which furthers suffering and slavery. You know, the depths that the dark occult will go and are, you know, going on now with division is unimaginable. It truly is unimaginable. But that's why you have to become aware of these things, so that way you can start to see it. You can start to really imagine like how far they will go. The fifth method is indoctrination. And this method is about obfuscation of indoctrination, especially the indoctrination of the left brain modality of consciousness. You know, the more left brain we are, the more we live in ego. We live in materialism, and we learn many types of useless math rather than holistic, creative right brain functions, you know, holistic intelligence, you know, the creative side, the holistic, you know, the big world picture, you know, thinking and seeing. You know, it's about modern so-called education that looks to indoctrinate obedience and conformity into its subjects. People are rewarded for memorization rather than to think and reason. It's also about the obvious propaganda filled into the minds of children till they're adults, you know, to make them never question the authority. Especially, you know, the authority of religious institutions, including, you know, science and government. You know, not just the religious institutions of, you know, Christianity, Islam, and Judaism. Okay, so on to the next method of manipulation, and this one is controlled opposition, which is part of the divide and conquer strategy. This is the idea that, you know, there are two opposing forces at work, but what's really going on is they, the opposing forces, especially the, you know, smaller groups at the top, are behind the curtains shaking hands and working together. They're not actually working against each other. And you can even, you know, see a very, you know, low resolution of this when a left-wing politician and right-wing politician duke it out on TV and then right after go hold hands while they golf and watch the sunset. You know, it's like George Carlin said, it's a big club and you ain't in it. But yeah, it's also about the illusion of choice. You know, there's two doors, your choice between the left door or the right door, and both go to the slaughterhouse, essentially, you know, which one will you choose? Yeah, that's really what it's about, you know, keeping us divided and making us, you know, think we have a quality choice in the political game. And people have a real hard time facing this fact because they want to believe it works instead of doing the shadow work to really see how it truly works. That's where you'll find the gold. The next method of manipulation is the financial system. And this is pretty much the most powerful of the methods used. It is definitely the most ingrained into our culture, and it is, you know, the biggest religion of our world, which is the frivolous paper we call money, you know, or, you know, what Brandon refers to it as shit paper. It is the system of fiat currency. There are, you know, special interests, banking cartels, printing or, you know, digitally inserting money at the whims of their own discretion. They control the interest rate on the money that is loaned to us by the Federal Reserve, which loans out money at interest that could never be paid back because every dollar is loaned to us at a certain percent of interest. We can never pay back the privately owned Federal Reserve Bank because they control the interest rate. So it's a vicious perpetual bondage of debt slavery through maritime admiralty law, and it's about taxation. You know, taxation being legalized slavery because of a group of people calling themselves government who, you know, somehow have been granted the right to confiscate an arbitrary chosen percentage of the product of labor of another individual's property. You know, and I know that can be very confusing for a lot of people, but, you know, that's really important to understand. So the eighth method of manipulation is the control of mass media, which is the weaponization of history and current affairs poured into the minds of the masses, mostly through heavy propaganda aired on mainstream news outlets to steer our emotions and basically develop a synthetic way to see the world. It's about telling us what to think rather than how to think. It's to keep us from ever thinking we could ever know anything other than what we're told. and it's mostly always fear-based information, which keeps us in the lower vibration of consciousness, which causes our energy to stay in fight or flight, you know, in the R complex of the brain. They know we'll react in fear to every horrific event, which is where the mind is super easy to manipulate. And this is really the only reason for mass mainstream media, because it's all about control. It's all about controlling where our minds are going. The ninth manipulation is that of food and medicine, which in this context is the genetically modified food with the cancer-causing agent of glyphosate, with other insane amounts of chemicals in the, you know, pesticides sprayed on the veggies and fruits and nuts and pretty much all the non-organic foods. And, you know, even the soil and water that's used to grow these foods is chemically induced. And, you know, not to mention the animals we consume are, you know, tortured and pumped with hormones, you know. And this is what weakens our immune systems. People don't understand that. All this is done for the sole purpose to starve people of needed nutrients. You know, it's all for easier control. And this is the same with the modern chemically altered medicines that create more illness and death rather than high percentages of health and wellness. It's about treating people as clients rather than patients. They need sick people to, you know, keep coming back or they lose business. It's really messed up, you know. So, you know, good luck on finding a cure in mainstream medicine. The 10th method of manipulation is the illusion of time. And this is about time as a physical thing, an ego identity. It's about believing that the next moment is more important than this moment. This is also about the fear of the future and living in the past. It's about not knowing and understanding the presence of now, you know, living in the now. And that's really what the entirety of life truly consists of, aligning and living in the present moment. You know, the illusion of time is also about thinking you have all the time to do all the fun things in life before taking life serious and being truly responsible. You know, responsible to discover natural law, essentially, to be honest. The 11th method is the DHR factor, which is the denial, harassment, or you can say hassle, and ridicule factor. And the first part, the denial part, is the cognitive dissonance or refusal of information. It's the, you know, hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil behavior. Martin Luther King said, "In the end, we will remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends." And he also said, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter." And, you know, it's so true. You know, social anxiety is one of the reasons people become deniers and then harass and ridicule those who speak uncomfortable truths, the things that truly matter. And social anxiety is the chronic mental health condition in which one becomes fearful to speak up about what truly matters due to fear of judgment, harassment, fear of ridicule, fear of embarrassment, humiliation, you know, fear of losing relationships and, you know, or fear of the concern of offending someone. And, you know, I see this a lot, and I've been guilty of this as well. I know many people who won't speak up at all, mostly for fear of losing friends. But most just want to go along to get along. That's really what it is. And that's really about living in a lie, to be honest. I mean, you know, I get there's many social justice warriors out there who are hard to, you know, speak up to because they bully the conversations with nonsense. And I mean things that really do not matter. And those types of people don't even give this type of information a realistic chance, mostly because they're not honest people at the heart, you know? And, you know, when you're in large groups of people who you know, all agree on something that you, you know, can't get behind because, you know, you know what they're saying is dogmatic, it gets really hard to speak up, especially if they're all set on, you know, what they're talking about being the truth, the absolute truth. And this is why we need to learn things like the Socratic method, which can lessen the egoic, confrontation. And also, you just got to, you know, get around like minds, like-minded people, so you have a voice that can be heard. And, you know, this can give you the courage to, you know, being around like-minded people can give you the courage to speak up around the people who typically reject the information you want to share. It's about being confident and brave and speaking up about what matters. That's part of true care and standing up for truth. Okay. So for the next method, I am going to give an overview of institutionalized religion. You know, this is about the religion and binding. And then I'm going to explain its meaning in correspondence with the maze cube. So first, on all organized religions, they all share a core truth within them. They have to, or, you know, people wouldn't follow. That's really important to understand. Religion, in the sense of organized religion, is believed blindly by common believers as absolute truth. Religion is a methodology of manipulation through fear, intended to control its followers through mind control. It's about preying on those who are naive. And it's also about preying on primal fears, and it utilizes people's lack of self-knowledge against them. Those at the apex of these religious institutions know they can control those who never explore and study knowledge of self, you know, in the realm in which the self operates. And this is all part of the destruction of the imagination, which is something that I'm going to get into on future shows. These priests, whether in government or church, use fear of the unknown to manipulate and steer the mind into mental cages. And what isn't ever taught or talked about is this: nobody needs a priest or religious authority figure between themselves and the intelligent divine creator. Nobody needs the authority of man to be the middleman between you and the intelligent nature of the universe. Now, the binding of religion is what really needs to be deeply understood, because it underlines all areas of where attention and belief unify, which generates dead ends or cul-de-sacs. And this is religare, which means to tie back, to bind, to thwart forward progress and consciousness. And just as a reminder, religare is the etymology of religion. So essentially, it means binding or the holding back of progress of an individual from getting to the objective truth. The objective truth about the nature of a thing or the self. You know, it's about keeping one from knowing purpose or from spiritually aligning to the higher degrees of the divine. So what are the things that hold us back? I'm going to explain this symbolically with the maze cube slides. So first, it's important to understand a few things about the black cube, because that's what this maze is aligned with. The black cube encompasses all life, and it could be likened to, you know, a box of all possibilities and dead ends, or the 3D material worldview. It also symbolizes the black hole of the universe. It's the womb with all the stars and planets within it. You know, we'll definitely cover more on the black cube in the future shows. That's a really important topic to cover. You know, just the cube alone is really important to, you know, understand. So we will be covering that in future shows for sure. So, looking at the slides for this part of the show, this maze cube, or box, or labyrinth, is like starting in ignorance, you know, roaming around like a rat in a maze. The dead ends are equivalent to religare. They are pockets of religion in the truest sense of the word. The binding of religion. It's about the parts of our journey that we tend to get stuck in, and we become held back in consciousness as a result. There are many, 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 many of these parts or dead ends or traps. The point of life is to figure out the maze. And obviously, it's not a physical maze. It's intelligent. It's paradoxical. It has no real beginning and no real end. No one can solve your maze for you. The maze is your unique journey. It's your mind and your experiences. It's full of traps or cul-de-sacs. And all recognized traps generate consciousness. Some people spend weeks in these traps, and some spend their whole life in one trap. Some examples would be like, you know, someone spending 30 years in an abusive relationship, you know, not ever being alone and not healing and finding peace. Or following a sports team for 20 plus years, knowing all the names and stats and the lives of all the players, and, you know, what foods they eat or what cars they drive. You know, many spend tons of hours a day for decades playing video games, or, you know, some spend their whole life memorizing all their favorite songs. Many watch news all day, every day, including porn. You know, many people spend years never reading a book, or any good ones at that. Some people spend many, many years exploring and trying to prove conspiracy theories, like, you know, spending 60 years searching for, you know, grays, you know, extraterrestrials and other realms, or spending a decade trying to prove the shape of the earth. Or 40 years trying to prove Paul McCartney is dead and who we're really seeing is Paul McCartney. Or spending 50 years trying to expose who shot JFK, John F. Kennedy. Or spending 25 years explaining that we're being sprayed by chemtrails. Or 30 years exposing that GMOs are poison to our health, or 45 years that the elections are rigged, you know? This is all about the ego sensationalizing these topics rather than getting to the core problem or getting to the truth. And this is not to, you know, put any researchers' work in vain. Lots of what they try to expose is very, very, very much appreciated and helpful for sure. And, you know, when it comes to institutionalized religion, so many people spend most of their lives stuck believing and having faith in something they've never honestly questioned. And these institutionalized religions or cul-de-sacs are Christianity, Judaism, Islam. You know, those are the three major ones. And there's Hinduism, Buddhism, Taoism, Confucianism, New Ageism, and a few more. And yes, atheism is also just another cul-de-sac. It also holds humanity back from forward progress in consciousness. It is also a religion. And I know this from lots of experience. Most atheists just can't be honest about this. Some other important binding religions that nobody really seems to understand that is also holding us back in consciousness is spending years and decades and lifetimes believing in man as authority, you know, like the belief in politicians or police or scientism, you know, the belief in scientists the having all the answers. Or spending years and decades and lifetimes believing in government. Or spending years and decades and lifetimes chasing money. Or spending years and decades and lifetimes willfully avoiding truth altogether. Imagine that. The point here is there are many traps or cul-de-sacs, but it's the cleverness of our intelligent minds that keeps moving in and out and all around all the traps of the maze to get closer and closer to truth and, you know, understanding the greater meaning of all this, you know, which is really only something you can discover for yourself. But I can tell you that lessening the suffering and slavery on this planet is one of the biggest reasons we're here in our search for truth, because we are all individually sovereign beings in nature, and we're here together. You know, we're meant to discover natural law and live in accord with it so we can defend truth and ourselves and help others free themselves from man's immoral, arbitrary religious chains and belief systems, you know? Contemplating and staying open and honest to all the possibilities and seeing how they all relate, that's what healthy research is really like. That's what helps us understand the cube, or, you know, this maze cube. And that's what will ultimately free us from the trappings of this maze. This is about the journey of the hero, which can only be you. You're the hero of your journey. No one else can save you. No one's coming to save you. You have to figure this out for yourself. This is all about true spirituality, because it's all about transcending dogma and recognizing truth is the one true religion. And obviously, you could gather a compendium or large detailed amounts of information of each one of these subjects, which I'm not against, but make sure to not fill your cup up too full and not be able to have enough room for, you know, the more important discoveries. It's not about being omniscient, you know, knowing everything. It's about gathering what makes sense. And, you know, what can lessen slavery? you know, lessen the slavery within. So that way one can help lessen the extreme aggregated slavery that's currently taking place in our world. Okay, guys, this episode is at its end. Hope you found clarity and value in this show today, and you can find more shows, presentations, and news here at cubbyhole.com. That's CubbyWhole.com. Also, please make sure to keep your eyes out for Douglas Martin on the next show, going further into barriers to self-realization. And after that, the next couple of shows should be Brandon, who will be going further into the methods of manipulation, especially subversive symbolism and chaos sorcery, which I may be joining him for those shows because they're going to be long. And as for now, a new show comes out every Monday at 6 p.m. Pacific time and every Friday at 12 p.m. Pacific time. So stay tuned for more. I'm your host, Nate Cap. Thank you, and keep transcending dogma.